Hi, I'm Julian Bliss, and I'm here in Denver at the International Clarinet Association show. There's a lot of people here this year, about between 1,700 and 2,000. It's a lot of clarinet players, but the atmosphere is great, and it's really nice to see everybody and to see all of the new things that everyone's got out. And Vandoren is no exception. They've got a nice amount of new and exciting things. I thought, first of all, I'd explain a little bit about my setup. A question that I do get asked quite a lot. I've played Vandoren products for a number of years, very, very proud to be a Vandoren artist. And for me, it all started with the reeds. I think for a lot of people it does. And I tried all of the different cuts, but for me, the traditional, the blue box, as it's nicknamed, in a strength 5, sometimes a 4, is really what suited my playing. I found I could get a warmth of sound that I had in my head, but also really nice, a great flexibility and good response as well when playing staccato, which is very important. Then a handful of years ago, came out with the BD4, I think the second or the third mouthpiece in the Black Diamond series. And as soon as I tried it, I fell in love. Again, you know, I found that the sound, the darkness of sound, was close to what I had in my mind, the sound I wanted to create. But also the flexibility, it sort of paired very well with the reeds, I felt. Very recently, actually moved to the 13 series, which, you know, is a personal preference. The 13 series, as I'm sure you know, is slightly lower pitched. But I think there is a slight sound difference as well. So my setup now is the 13 BD4 13 series with the traditional the blue box reed, because Denver's quite high up at the moment. I'm playing on 4s, and last of all, the new, that's a relatively new now, carbon fiber ligature. I was lucky enough to be at a show a handful of years ago, and I got to try one of the first prototypes of this ligature. And beforehand, I played a rose gold MO Masters ligature, and I loved that. But as soon as I put this one on, it changed everything. I found I got a lovely, rich, and dark sound from it. So I didn't expect it, actually. But as soon as I put it on, I was hooked. And I wanted to take home the prototype, but they wouldn't let me. So I had to wait, very patiently waited for a couple of years until the manufacturing, until the production ones were available. But yeah, for me, this setup and the combination of all of those things kind of allows me to play the way I want to play, with the least inhibitions. And that's what we all really search for. And yeah, it's sort of a perfect marriage of all of these things. So yeah, it's very thankful for Vandoren for making these fantastic products. So of course I can talk about how it feels and how I think it sounds, but I think it's best if I just play something. I'm really looking forward to my concert. I have a recital here on Saturday evening, and playing a handful of what you could call sort of conventional, well-loved repertoire, sort of Poulenc and Brahms, but also playing a fantastic piece by Robert Schumann, Adagio and Allegro, the Opus 70, which is not often done on clarinet, but I think it works quite well. I am slightly biased, of course, but I do think it works quite well. So I'll play the beginning of that as a little teaser before tomorrow night's concert. So there's a very short teaser, just the beginning of Adagio and Allegro. And now for something with a little bit more punch. Let's go to the great sonata by Francis Poulenc.